Today I'm going to show you how to create an IPsec VPN tunnel between two DrayTech routers. On one side there is a 20136 DrayOS 5 router in a dial-in mode, and on the other side we have a 2927 LAX in a dial-out mode. The LAN and WAN IP addresses are shown in this diagram so that you can follow the VPN configuration better. We'll now log in on the 2136 and go to the VPN side-to-side tab. Click on Add to add a new VPN profile like this one and name it as 2927. We slide the enable switch and check the direction to be dial-in. We then select the VPN type as IPsec and enable the IPsec dial-in protocol as IKV1/V2. The dial-in allowed schedule is always allowed, and if you want a schedule, then you can enter it here. Now for the dial-in settings, we keep the main mode for negotiation. We will use aggressive if the other side is behind a NAT. Then we slide the specify VPN peer button. Here we can type in the remote IP, which is 192.168.100.70, and enter the pre-shared key specific for this VPN profile. Note that there is a general side-to-side PSK which can also be used for all other IPsec VPNs if this site-specific key is not entered, and this is found under the VPN General Setup tab. This is a site-specific pre-shared key. Also here you can enable any X509 certificate if it is being used. We can now type in the IKE identifier and have local ID as 2136 and PID as 2927, just in case we need it later. If we click on More Settings, we can adjust the IKE two-phase settings such as Perfect Forward Secret and Dead Peer Detection settings, but we will leave them as default now. Now we go to the network settings and type in the local network IP and the remote network IP, and select routing mode. Note that if NAT mode is selected, only the dial-out clients can see the entire network, but the dial-in clients are not allowed to see the dial-out network. We enter remote subnets if we have more than one LAN subnet to connect to on the other side of the VPN. Then we click Apply to save the VPN profile. Now we will go to the 2927. We will first check that the IPsec VPN service is turned on. Note that the VPN services are all turned off by default in the latest firmware. Then we go to the LAN-to-LAN tab and add a new index. Here is a profile we created beforehand. We'll name it 2.21.36. The call direction is dial out and the path is through 1.1.1. The idle timeout is -1. Which means it will keep the VPN on all the time. We now select IPsec tunnel with IKEV1 and then type the pre-shared key and the local ID to be 2927. We then insert the remote WAN IP, which is 192.168.100.67, and finally type in the LAN IP as 192.168.11.0 and the remote LAN IP is 192.168.1.0. Click OK to save the settings. We can now see our VPN profile setup and already online as displayed in green. We can confirm that in the connection management, which will show VPN1, with IPsec being online, the uptime of the VPN is also displayed. We can now jump to the 2136 and see the VPN connection status with all the details. And you can also drop the VPN tunnel by clicking on the drop button. And on the side-to-side VPN tab, you will see the online status displayed in green. This concludes our demo on how to create a LAN-to-LAN VPN tunnel between two DrayTech routers.